What's going on, guys? Blink here, back with a new video. Today we're going to talk about the new hunting rifle and how to implement it in your playstyles. But before we get started, the V-Bucks giveaway is still going on, so visit the link in the description to enter. And lastly, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications as I post an Amazon gift card code in the comments every time I upload. By turning on notifications, you'll have a way better chance of getting here first and redeeming that code. Anyways, guys, let's get this video started. This gun is absolutely insane and I fell in love with it the first shot I took. I was working on another guide for you guys, but I had to stop it and just make this hunting rifle guide. It's the first sniper without a scope to be featured in the Battle Royale mode. Also, what makes this unique compared to the scope rifles is that you can use this more comfortably at closer to medium ranges. Now, I don't think the hunting rifle replaces the sniper in any way. They both have really good uses in different situations, but we'll get into the different ways of using it shortly. There are two different rarity grades, green which is uncommon and blue which is rare. You can find the hunting rifle in chests and spawned guns. Surprisingly, so far I haven't been able to find them that often. It seems like they both spawn epic and rare grades, so hopefully they increase the drop rate for them. Anyways, let's get into the stats. The green will do 86 to the body and 215 to the head, while the blue will do 90 to the body and 225 to the head. They both take heavy bullets and can be used in close, medium, and long range situations. There's also a decently sized zoom when you right click. Not that crazy, but a good amount to take a crispier shot. So it is a harder gun to use in long range situations because it's a lot harder to see targets, and you don't have a reticle that can help you estimate the range of a player. But when you played a lot of Fortnite, you'll be able to guess the distances players are, and it's pretty satisfying to hit targets from long ranges. Now, I'd say it's most comfortable to use at medium distances, but if you're pretty insane, then you can use it at any distance comfortably. It's also easy to adjust your reticle on players' heads because you don't have to unscope the gun if you miss. You can keep that crosshair on the player and just wait to shoot again, but your best bet is to unscope and move around a little before re-scoping back in so you don't get shot. I also feel like it's easier to hit headshots compared to a sniper, but that might be me. Although, focus on going for them headshots anyways because the damage more than doubles. Now, I tried to figure out if you can make a meta for this gun, and I played a bunch of games today trying to figure it out. And honestly, using the hunting rifle and then switching to the AR would be your best bet. Basically, same thing you do with the bolt action. It doesn't really replace shotguns because if an enemy is in your face, you're not really going to want to pull out the hunting rifle since you only have one bullet that can potentially hit compared to the shotgun with up to 9 pellets that will have a better chance of hitting your target. So, if you're pushing a player with consistent movement, then don't pull out the hunting rifle because the chance of you hitting a jumping shot or a moving shot isn't as good as if you had a shotgun. Using it aggressively works very well as long as you have cover. It's also very comfortable to use in medium to close range situations. I've used it plenty of times already end game in 1v1 situations and it works so well. If you're like me and you love sniping at close range distances, then the difference between this and a sniper rifle in an end game medium to close range scenario is that if you use a sniper rifle, you'll end up needing to readjust your aim some of the times because of the close range scope, which does make it a little harder, but it is doable. And sometimes it might be better to pull out the AR or even the pump if he's that close. But with this beastly of a gun, it's so much easier to aim in just with that little bit of zoom, which is perfect and super comfortable in close to medium situations. So I'll explain two good setups depending on your playstyle. I'll tell you my favorite first: an AR, tactical shotgun, or tactical submachine gun, pump, hunting rifle, and some sort of meds. This setup is perfect if you're confident in your long-range hunting rifle abilities. The pros of this setup will allow you to use the hunting rifle at close and medium distances too, which gives you more options to decide if you want to pull out your pump, your AR, or pull out the hunting rifle depending on your situation. Basically, you can use this close, medium, and long range if you are confident in your long-range abilities. This next setup that will be for players that want that long range bolt too. So you'd have an AR, tactical shotgun or tactical submachine gun or pump, hunting rifle, bolt sniper, and some sort of meds. You can use that bolt for a more comfortable long range snipe, but use the hunting rifle for closer to medium distances if you'd like. Depending on how you play, you have to choose one of the three weapon options I touched on. If you're a strong builder, you can use the pump for that extra critical damage. You'd have that delay between shots, but after every pump shot, build more cover if needed and readjust for another pump shot. Or use the tactical shotgun or tactical submachine gun for the aggressive pushing after hitting your hunting rifle shot. These are the two setups I've only touched upon because it replaces the issue for the far distances the hunting rifle can be hard to use at. There are many more setups, but I was focused on more towards fixing the potential weaknesses for some with the hunting rifle. Maybe in the future I'll make an updated video on all the setups you can be using depending on your playstyle. Well, that's it for this guide. I do hope to make some cool strats with this gun really soon, but I need to put more time into the gun anyways. If you guys have enjoyed this hunting rifle guide, a like and a sub would be greatly appreciated as it does help me a lot. Also, let me know in the comments below if you guys like this new hunting rifle or not. Anyways, guys, have a great rest of your day or night, and I'll see you on the next one.